Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to create sales receipts in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. A sales receipt is a document that provides customers with a detailed description of the products or services that they have purchased from you. If you receive a payment from a customer at the time of sale, then you would create a sales receipt in QuickBooks to record both the sale and payment. Refer to the text part of this lesson to learn how the sales receipt affects the accounts and financial statements. When you create a sales receipt in QuickBooks, you get a couple of benefits. One, your financial statements are updated in real time to reflect the change in your income and bank account balances. Second, you can email sales receipts to your customers directly from QuickBooks so that your customers have a detailed record of the products and services that they purchased from you. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, after you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the plus sign on the homepage and navigate to the sales receipt section. This is the sales receipt form on your screen. We will go ahead and complete these fields for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. So the first field is the customer name. If you have not set up your customer information yet, you can do so by clicking on the dropdown and scrolling up to the top of the list to select Add New. In the Setting Up Customers lesson, we walked through how to set up customer profiles. Click this link to watch this video tutorial. Email address. This information will automatically populate from the customer profile. If you did not enter the email address in the customer profile, then this field will be blank. You can enter the email directly into this field and it will automatically update the customer profile. Billing address. This information will automatically populate from the customer profile. If you did not enter the billing address in the customer profile, then this field will be blank. You can enter the billing address directly in this field, but it will not automatically update the customer profile. You will have to go back to the customer profile and enter this information for it to automatically populate going forward. Sales receipt date. This is typically the date of the sale to your customer. Typically, QuickBooks will default to today's date. If you are creating the sales receipt sometime after the date that you made the sale, then you will need to change this date. Payment method. Select the payment method from the drop-down list here. The options are cash, check, and credit card. If you have an Intuit Payments account, select credit card for the payment method and enter your customer's credit card information. Once you save the sales receipt, QuickBooks will process the credit card payment and a message will display on the screen to inform you whether the credit card payment was accepted or declined. We will go ahead and select check payment here. And then in the reference field, if your customer did pay by check, you want to enter the check number in this field. If the payment method was not checked, then you can enter any information here that will help you reference the payment later on. The deposit to field is where you want to select the bank account that you will deposit this payment to from the drop down here. So we'll go ahead and select Bank of America. The products and services section is where you want to select each product or service that you sold to your customer. If you have not set up the products and services information yet, you can do so by clicking the drop down and scrolling up to the top and selecting Add New. In the Setting Up Products and Services lesson, we walked through how to set up products and services that you sell to your customers. Click this link to watch this video tutorial. So we will go ahead and complete our products and services information for our customer. So keep in mind that the description field will automatically populate based on the description used to set up the product or service. You can also enter directly into the sales receipt a custom description here, but it will not update the product and service item. To do so, in order for this description to automatically populate going forward, you will have to go back and set up products and services. You want to enter the quantity field if applicable and the rate, and then QuickBooks will calculate the amount by multiplying the quantity and the rate fields. Once you are satisfied at the information on the sales receipt, go ahead and do a print preview to see what it looks like. And here is our completed sales receipt for our fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. After you are satisfied with the sales receipt, you can either print it out and mail it to your customer, or you can email it directly from QuickBooks. So we'll go ahead and close out of the print preview window and email this sales receipt to Paul's customer. So go ahead and click on the Save and Send button in the lower right-hand corner, and that will bring up the send email form for us to take a look at. On the left-hand side, you'll see the send email information, and on the right-hand side is a preview of the sales receipt that we want to send to our customer. The email address is automatically populated from the customer profile here. The subject line consists of the sales receipt number that was issued by QuickBooks along with the company name. You can edit this information if you'd like. And then the body of the email is what's going to appear here. This is customizable and you can edit it, put a custom message here if you'd like for that as well. Once you are satisfied with this information, you want to click the Save to Send, Queue, and Close button. Be sure to check your email delivery settings before sending emails to your customers. We covered this in the How to Set Up Sales Form content lesson. To access this lesson, click on this link. That wraps up the lesson on how to create sales receipt in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.